General Manor and Weston's Bank.
It's me, Dobbs. I forgot my key.
Right, sir.
Tory, I couldn't get a taxi, and I think I've caught a cold.
Oh, no, sir.
I may go home early.
That's impossible, Mr. Tony. The General's called a board meeting for 1600 hours.
Oh, no.
He left orders, sir. You're to vote yes.
I am?
Yes, sir.
Look, where is my father? I have to speak to him.
Upstairs in the penthouse, sir, but...
Not to be disturbed.
You're right, sir.
Do you like it, Horace?
Damn fine battle dress.
Oh, thank you.
Let's get started. Not much time.
Can't I be the British just for once?
No, 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 no. You're the Boers. I'm the British. Your first move. Enemy always starts the war.
Right. My infantry attack and engage your field regiment.
Yes, but I make a tactical withdrawal.
Are you sure you want to do that?
Routine maneuver. What's wrong with it?
Well, you see, sir, I've been working out some new tactics. Uh-huh. I move my light brigade up here behind you.
I was expecting you to do that.
Got you. Teeny weeny pincer movement. Mafeking's cut off.
What?
I mount an attack on your entire disposition. Kitchener is captured, and you've lost the war. I advise you ask for terms.
Sue for peace.
Unconditional surrender.
Good.
Yes? Right. Change of plan. Board meeting.
Oh. I'll get the lift for you, Horace, dear.
No, 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 no. Take the stairs. Keep fit.
You're in lovely shape, Horace.
Not bad when older. They'll be expecting me to take the lift. Never do what the other fella expects. Back soon.
At ease.
Is he coming?
Not yet.
Now remember, we're all together on this. We vote no. Agnes, you point out the tax position and the capital gains disadvantage.
It's a straight disposal of assets situation.
Added to which the Deutschmark is rising and the sterling position is weak.
As for you, Tony, I count on you to vote with us.
Morning, Father.
Good afternoon, General.
Good afternoon.
Are you well?
Deutschmark's up. Should have finished them off in 45. Pass the Madeira. Business before the board is the proposed merger with Travers and Crony. All studied it?
Yes.
I find the terms favourable. Propose to accept. However, we are a democratic body. Vote as you please, Mr. Tite.
Well, having considered all the details, I'm against it. I vote no.
Got to point out, only two directors on joint board. Anyone opposed, natural candidate for redundancy. Now, Mr. Tice, yes or no?
Well, on reflection, I vote yes.
Rentoul?
Yes.
Agnes?
At the end of the day, this merger would involve us in a tax liability of some...
Not interested, yes or no?
Yes.
Good. Unanimous.
Father.
That's all, thank you.
I abstain.
Rubbish. Any other business? Meeting closed. Good day to you.
Sir! General!
Horace.
I can't see him. He's not making a sound.
Oh, my God.
you think that he's... I mean, could he possibly be...
Father! Are you all right, Father? All right? Of course I'm not all right, you bloody fool! I've broken my arm!
If you're going to ask me how I am, Esther, I'm not well.
Oh, dear.
Yesterday I thought I was getting a cold.
Whiskey and hot lemon?
I took it. Woke up this morning with a hangover. I'd rather have the cold. I may even still have it.
Do we have an appointment? I thought our next session was on Friday.
Yes, I know. I had to call in. Are you busy?
Well, there's just my daily charge.
I hope not, because it's a crisis in my life.
Trouble with your father again?
He's a despot, a tyrant.
He's dominant Aries pattern.
A dictator. To him, I'm a minion, a serf.
You're Taurus. He exploits your family loyalty.
He does.
Something's happened to him?
Yes. Yesterday, he walked into a lift and it wasn't there.
Was he badly injured?
Not the general. Anyone else would have broken their neck. He sprained his arm.
Well, look, if the lift wasn't there, how did the doors open?
That's what he wants to know.
Yes, he's probably suspicious and thinks someone's trying to kill him.
Yes?
Probably suspects you.
Actually, yes.
Ridiculous. You have a natural Taurian facility.
I'm going to overcome it. Leave, resign from the bank. I mean, I can't go on being treated like a teenage imbecile. I'm 32.
Yes, Tony, we know.
So I'm through. No, I mean it this time.
Like you meant at the time before.
No, this is different. We all have a breaking point and mine's broken. Tomorrow I tell him. However...
You want to make sure the aspects are favourable?
Well, there's no point in going off half-cocked. I mean, if you do a chart and tell me it's a bad time for decisions, I can always resign next month.
Of course.
So, bring it tonight to the bank.
Doesn't look a bit like Barton, does it? Where do you keep the cash?
We don't have money, nothing like that.
No bullion, no vaults.
Got a wine cellar downstairs. Not even for drinking, for investment. Meet the family.
Very formidable.
They are. If you're descended from them and rose to the dizzy heights of a lance corporal in the catering corps. What's wrong? You cold?
No, I've just got an odd feeling.
Well, I'm not surprised. That's Father you're looking at. Has exactly the same effect on me.
Tony, let's get started.
It's bad news, isn't it?
Well, it's fixed.
I knew it.
Look, just relax.
I am relaxed. Perfectly relaxed. A drink. I'll get some ice.
No, thanks.
No drink?
Just sit down.
Sit down. Tommy, then, I'm ready.
Now, to begin with, we have Jupiter in your 11th house.
That's bad.
That's good.
Good?
It's well situated, so it's a promising time for friendships.
Friendships?
You've no problems with your health, but you have to be aware of exhausting yourself emotionally.
I feel exhausted.
We have Uranus in your opposite sign this month.
That's good.
Bad.
Bad.
You have to be careful of unexpected happenings.
I expected that.
We also have a retrograding Mercury.
I don't like the sound of that.
Mercury being the planet of the mind, it's not a time to make decisions. With Mercury in retrograde, it causes hold-ups and delays. Adverse conditions in your professional career.
I really am in dreadful shape.
No, you're not. But just don't do anything impulsive.
I won't do anything at all.
Well, next month, Venus, your own ruler, enters your birth sign. There should be a big improvement next month.
But how do I get through this month? And all that unexpected retrograding? I don't like that. Now, have a drink. Because I need one. Oh, my God! Help!
What's the matter?
It's him.
Who?
He's in there, in the fridge.
Who?
The general.
Well, ask him to come out.
He can't.
Well, don't be ridiculous.
Well, see if I'm being ridiculous. Go on, look.
Well, how do you open it?
Press the button.
Well, go on then, press it. I'm sorry. I couldn't help it.
Who is it this time? Do we know the deceased?
General Sir Horace Mannering Weston.
Who?
General Sir Horace Mannering Weston.
Oh, that makes my night. Where is he? You may not know it, but I was at a charity dinner, escorting a debutante of the year.
Which year?
Never mind. Quite a recent vintage. You ruined her evening.
I'm so sorry.
Well?
Go ahead, press that button. It opens the refrigerator.
Hmm. Good God.
Well, aren't you going to examine him?
I think he'll keep.
Oh, the stuff is changing. He's just opening his trailer. Mm.
Now, who was with you when you found the body?
Tony Weston, the General's son.
Where is he?
Upstairs in his office, recovering from the shock.
Hmm. Is one permitted to ask what you were doing here with him?
Casting his horoscope. He's a client.
Why here? Why at this time of night?
Well, he phoned about 8 and suggested that we meet here. I hadn't been inside a private bank before, and I thought, why not?
Was he here when you arrived?
Yes.
What time was that?
8:30.
Hmm. The General must have been already dead.
Yes.
Convenient that you were here when he found the body.
Look, you're barking up the wrong tree already. He couldn't have killed the General.
I'll decide that. Why not?
There's nothing in his natal chart to show he'd be likely to commit a murder.
There isn't?
No. The position of Venus in his birth sign shows him incapable of violence.
Hmm. Well, perhaps you'll go and fetch him. I'll ask him a few questions.
All right.
Meanwhile, I'll have a look around. See if there's any money missing.
Grad,
hmm?
This is a merchant bank. They don't keep money in a merchant bank.
They don't?
Oh, I thought everybody knew that. Ooh.
What do you mean he's not here? He must be here somewhere.
I know he must, but I can't find him.
That's very odd. We'd better start at the top of the building and work our way down.
Darling, you've been ages. Horace?
No, I'm Gradley.
If you're burglars, it's not that sort of bank.
Terrible shock for you.
Mm.
You must be brave, Miss...
Prentice. Julie Prentice. Mm.
Dreadful thing to have happened.
Mm. Oh.
Oh, I have a hanky here somewhere. There.
Oh, thank you. Oh, Reeve Gauche. It's my favourite. Oh.
All right, Miss Jones. I'll handle this.
Oh.
Thank you.
You feeling better?
Oh, I'm sorry, it's all wet.
Never mind. Look, I'll go downstairs while you change. And then perhaps I can ask you a few questions, eh?
Oh, I'll try. But couldn't you stay here while I slip into something more comfortable?
Well,
I'd be so scared on my own.
Oh, well, in that case, sir.
Thank you. I'll just go in there so I won't embarrass you.
All right. You were a close friend of the General's.
Yes. He was a widower, you see. He didn't get on with his son, so he spent most of his time up here.
Mm. What time did you last see him tonight?
About 7. He had a phone call from downstairs. He had to take care of something in the bank. He said to wait for him.
Do you know who the phone call was from?
One of the three directors, or Tony. Oh, poor Horace. He was so worried about the merger.
Merger? Mm. What merger?
Well, he was selling the bank, and the other directors were against it.
Why would he do a thing like that?
Well, for one thing, he didn't think Tony, his son, was capable of continuing the firm. He wanted to retire, enjoy himself. Mm. We were going to go and live in Spain. Oh, I think I'm going to cry again.
Oh, no, please don't.
Here.
Oh, thank you. No, keep it. You say the General went downstairs at 7?
Yes.
Hmm. Didn't it strike you strange that he was away so long?
Well, I was beginning to worry. He was so looking forward to after supper.
Was he?
We were going to play a game.
Game?
Well, it took his mind off things, relaxed him, made him forget his worries.
Did it? These games... What?
Every other night.
Where?
On the table.
On the table? Oh, war games. I thought... Fascinating.
Oh, what did you think I meant, Mr. Gradley?
Oh, something less cerebral. Ludo, dominoes, or...
Soldiers?
Soldiers.
I'm afraid I did.
How is he?
Well, he'll live. We'll get him down to the hospital for an x-ray.
How about the General?
No point in x-raying him.
I mean, what was the cause of death?
Oh, shot. Close range.
Hmm. Would you say something like that?
Something like that? Same fellow, I suppose. Did this and knocked off the General.
Hmm.
Tony, you've got to trust me. Where were you for the past hour, and what were you doing in the cellar?
I'll ask the questions, if you don't mind. Now, where were you for the last hour?
And why were you down in the cellar?
Are you going to arrest me?
Don't rush me. Sit down. Now, why were you in the cellar?
I was looking for Esther.
In the cellar?
No. Now, I heard someone moving around. I went down, I grabbed this bottle. I thought it must have been the murderer.
Oh, I see.
I didn't realize it was Dobbs till after I hit him.
So much for Venus and the position of non-violence.
I beg your pardon?
It was a pure reflex action.
When did you last see your father? In the fridge. Can you explain that?
I didn't kill him.
Oh, he thinks you did. Yesterday, down the lift shaft.
Well, yes, he did.
But you deny it.
Naturally, he denies it.
I deny it.
You deny it. Do you own a gun?
Me, never. I'm a pacifist.
Have you seen one on the premises?
A pacifist?
No, a gun.
Yes. A service revolver. The, General kept one in her desk in the boardroom.
I know, I've seen it. But it wasn't there earlier. Can you explain that? Were you about to say something, Esther?
Not me.
All right, Mr. Weston.
You're arresting me.
No, I'm not. You can go.
Go?
Home.
Good night.
Good night.
Good night.
Esther, I... Good night.
Good night.
Night.
What's wrong?
Old as the hills.
What is?
Cat and mouse. Too much crime and punishment. That's your trouble.
Look, he is obviously lying.
So send him away feeling guilty.
The question is, why did he lie?
Are you asking?
No. Telling. He lied because he killed his old man.
Look, I've told you, that's astrologically impossible. Impossible. It's outside the realms of feasibility. With Venus and Taurus in his sun, it gives him a basic desire for peace and stability.
All right, so he kills his old man and then he gets his peace and stability. Come on.
Where?
I'm taking you home. Oh. Making myself comfortable.
Do.
You don't mind?
No.
Oh, might be a long night.
Coffee?
Oh, good. Help keep me awake.
I'm not sleepy.
Oh, I am. I could doze off, but I mustn't. Not on the job.
If you say so.
Hope it doesn't take till morning.
Do you think it might?
What?
Take till morning.
It might. Do you mind? Thank you. No. He'll be here sooner than that. We know he's lying. And he knows we know. And he'll be here to explain. To you.
So that's why you're here. To catch Tony Weston off guard.
Well, why else?
Oh.
There's no sugar.
Esther!
He's here.
He's here?
Yes.
He's here.
Yes, he is, and I'm going to send him away.
Look.
He's being mean.
You want to prove him innocent, don't you?
I already know he's innocent.
Look, prove his innocence to me.
Look, I know. Wait. Go in there.
Barricades. Esther, I've got to talk to you.
Tony, it's late. Couldn't you come back in the morning?
No, no, I have to explain now.
Look, don't...
I lied to you and to that flatfoot.
Don't say anything you might regret.
You know I was lying. I could tell you knew.
Look, there's a draft. Come on.
Never mind that. Please, I want to explain. Don't try to stop me. I had to lie. I even had to hide it from you and the fuzz. I was in a spot and I needed time to think.
Oh, think now before you say any more.
I want to tell you, please, don't try to stop me. Now, what would you say if the files showed that I embezzled £200,000 from the firm and the gun that killed the general was in my desk and that I wiped it clean of fingerprints and put it back in the boardroom and I took the files and hid them in the cellar and that's why I had to hit Dobbs before he saw me? Esther, what would you say to that? Why do you keep making those funny faces?
I think she's trying to tell you that I'm here.
You set a trap.
No, she didn't, I did. Esther, would you, I can't seem to get it right.
Look, your horoscope said not to do anything impulsive.
I had to hide the gun. Someone's tried to frame me.
Esther, please.
And wiping those fingerprints.
Well, I picked it up and I thought that would be proof.
It's all right, thank you. Now, never mind the gun. What about the, this embezzling?
I didn't embezzle anything.
There's a file that says you did.
Yes.
Someone trying to frame you?
Yes, someone's worked very hard to make me look guilty.
Yeah, with a little help from you.
Well, I panicked. After all, I'm the logical suspect.
You said that.
Of course I am, aren't I, Esther?
Don't keep insisting on it, Tony.
Well, you all know I am. You're just keeping me in suspense, refusing to arrest me.
Tony, don't get rattled.
Who's rattled? I'm not rattled. You're just trying to make me crack up and admit I killed the general.
And did you?
No. It just looks that way.
Tell me one thing. Your father. Why do you keep calling him the general?
He felt more like a general than a father.
Gave you a bad time, did he?
Treated me like dirt.
So, in fact, you had every reason to kill him?
I even had a witness when I found the body.
I know that. Don't do my job for me.
Just seeing it from your point of view, Inspector.
Thank you very much. I can do that perfectly well myself.
Well, now that you're both working together, do you think you could go to your respective houses so we could all get some sleep?
I hardly think the inspector's going to let me go home, Esther.
Oh, he will. He hasn't made up his mind yet.
If you don't mind, Esther, I'll decide that for myself.
Fine with me. Good night, all.
Yes, well, I was about to say, it's getting late. All right, Mr. Weston.
You're arresting me.
No, I'm not. Not yet. Tell me one thing. How did you come here this evening?
By car.
Good. Can you give me a lift home?
Poor Horace.
Yes, he'll never thump another boardroom table.
But who could have done such a thing?
Almost anybody.
Pass the Madeira.
That's a dreadful thing to say. And where were you last night?
Let's not start accusing each other. We all had our little differences with the general, but de mortuis nil nisi bonum.
In other words, let's not knock the departed. I quite agree, old chap. Much safer.
How can you be so callous?
What we have to be, Agnes, is careful. All three of us.
What are you doing here?
Oh, that's friendly. I've come to help.
How?
Well, to start with, I thought I could do the charts of the possible suspects.
What suspects? I've questioned the staff. They're in the clear.
Well, let's begin with the directors.
I can hardly go in and ask for their birthdays now, can I? Anyway, I'm far too busy. I've got to talk to Miss Prentice.
Ah, now there's an interesting young lady.
What have you got against Miss Prentice?
I might ask you the same thing.
Not funny.
Ask her if she's born round about May the 25th, would you? I think she's a typical Gemini.
Do you mean two-faced?
Well, you're quick, but you mustn't jump to conclusions. Not all Gemini are like that, only some of them.
The first item of urgency is a statement to our clients to restore confidence. Now,
I'm sorry about this. Just carry on as if I weren't here, will you?
I think we ally this statement to a decision to stay out of equities this winter and to increase our property holdings.
I think gilt-edged might be safer. I mean, threat of a general election and all that.
Yes, well, I quite agree with that.
Sorry about this. Remain seated, please.
Miss Jones, investigation or not, we have to get on with the work of the bank.
Yes, I realise that, but the inspector has asked me to get a sample of your handwriting.
Why? He questioned us. He said nothing about handwriting.
Well, he wouldn't, Miss Courtney. He leaves all that sort of thing to me. Now, if you'd all just take pen to paper and write down your names. And your address?
Address, did you say? Oh.
Date of birth? That should do. Oh, and the time of birth, if you know it.
Time of birth? Have you got a pen, my dear friend? Thank you so much.
Funny, they're always behind pictures.
I didn't know about this until I found it last night. Mm.
Yes, it's a five-tumbler job. We'll need an expert. Oh, what a clever girl you are, Miss Prentice. Did you work the combination out yourself?
No, I found it in Horace's wallet.
Mm. I give and bequeath all my worldly possessions to...
Of course, I wasn't expecting it. I wasn't after his money. I just thought it might help you.
Yes, it will.
will.
Thank you.
And now you have to run away again.
Yes, I'm afraid so. Oh, this may seem strange, but is your birthday anywhere around May the 25th?
May the 26th? Aren't you clever?
Just a knack. Is there another way down?
How do you feel?
I feel marvellous.
You do?
Relaxed and at peace with the world.
Well, how did that happen?
Positive thinking. Those questions last night were a catharsis. I know I'm not guilty. Therefore, someone else must be. Yes, it's day one of a new approach to life.
Well, that's good.
Now, all we have to do is find the guilty party.
Well, I've made a start.
Look, when I need your help, I will ask for it. Now, what's all this about handwriting?
But you do need my help.
I have never been less in need of anyone's help in my entire career. I told you not to ask for their birth signs.
Nothing of the kind. You said you couldn't, so I did. We've got one Capricorn, one Pisces, and Miss Courtney's a Virgo.
Old Virgo. I might have guessed.
Oh, there you are.
Here I am, grumbly old man.
Gradley. What are you looking so pleased about?
Well, I wouldn't say pleased, but I do feel restored somehow.
Restored?
I've rejoined the human race. Last night, I slept like a baby, woke up with a clear conscience.
Why?
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 Because I am an innocent man.
You weren't last night.
I was, yes, but you confuse me, pointing to facts that seem to lead to my guilt. This morning I woke up and realized that we can work together and solve this, you and I and Esther.
I don't want to work with you and I and Esther. I have already solved it.
You have? Wonderful.
Who was it, Grad?
You mean you don't know? This will.
What?
Your father left everything to Julie Prentice, but before he could sign it, he was killed. Guess who inherits all the lolly?
Me?
You.
Oh, no.
Oh, yes. All right, Mr. Weston.
You're not arresting me.
I am.
You can't.
I can. Anthony Mannering Weston, I'm arresting you for the murder of your father, General Mannering Weston.
But I...
No. I should warn you that anything you say, please, may be taken down and used in evidence.
Swiss franc is up 4 points against sterling.
That makes a profit of 28% on our Zurich holdings.
Get Agnes to calculate the tax position. Oh, Agnes, the Zurich file. What's the tax position?
Well, haven't you heard? Tony's been arrested.
We have, as a matter of fact. Tragic, but inevitable.
Well, how can you go on as if it means nothing?
We have to carry on, Aggie. I mean, money markets change hourly. Our responsibility is to the bank and our clients.
One has to be realistic. His arrest was expected. Who else had a motive to kill the general?
Any one of us.
I wouldn't go around saying things like that if I were you. Really, Agnes. Uh-huh.
Thank you.
Cheers. I'm so glad the inspector's pleased with you.
Yes, yes, he was delighted. Called me upstairs, asked me to do 18 holes with him at Wentworth.
Oh, that's wonderful, Grant.
Yes.
Well, now, drink up your wine. How is it? A modest little flock?
I'm amused by its audacity.
Yes, I thought you would be.
Yes.
Ah.
You know, how you can think about food when you've arrested an innocent man, I don't know.
Quite simply, I'm starving. Anyway, he's not innocent. He's as guilty as old Nick. He had motive, opportunity. He's an erratic, father-fixated, neurotic nut.
Grant, he couldn't have done it. He's a perfect example of a placentaurian. He wouldn't harm a fly.
I'm not talking about harming flies. I'm talking about the moment when he up and shot his dad.
Do you accept the fact that astrology has a scientific basis?
I'm not sure. I accept the fact that you think it has, and sometimes you make me believe it.
Well, then will you hear me out?
If it gets me my dinner. Thank you.
Look, I've done both the charts of Tony and the General. There was an Aries-Taurus conflict. They're both horn signs of the zodiac.
Really?
And it led to acrimony and bitterness. But it couldn't have led to murder, certainly not last night.
Why not?
Well, although the full moon made certain aspects to Uranus, I just don't feel it could have led to murder.
I could just see myself telling the Commissioner that. You see, she doesn't actually feel...
Brad, I'll tell him.
No, I'm sorry, Esther. I'm sorry. This time you don't convince me. Sorry.
All right.
Look. I have nicked the right man.
But nothing more to be said.
Right.
Suppose by some chance I could prove that there'd been some dishonesty at the bank that you didn't know about. Would that reopen the case?
It might, but you can't.
Oh, Grad, do finish your wine.
No, I'm not thirsty.
You don't have to be thirsty to drink wine. Don't you like it?
Mmm. I'm very pleasant.
Oh, be truthful, it's an awful little plonk.
Well, if you really want me to be truthful...
I do.
It's an awful little plonk.
Can't compare it with anything the General kept in his cellar.
Oh, well, now you're talking about real wine. I mean, the General kept a superb cellar. Chateau Lafitte, 1947. A truly great wine.
Yeah.
This stuff, Algerian Beaujolais rubbish, slightly corked. Yeah, rubbish. Chateau Lafitte, 1947.
A truly great wine.
Ah, Inspector.
Morning, Mr. Dobbs. How's the head?
Considerably better, thank you, sir.
Good. What have we here?
Madeira and Bath Oliver, sir. We always serve Madeira to the directors at 11.
Really? And the show must go on, eh?
Would you care for...
Oh, no, thanks. I wouldn't mind a glass of wine, though.
Wine, sir?
Yes. How about some of your Chateau Lafitte, 1947?
Oh, no, sir. No, that's impossible. That wine's not to be touched. It's for investment purposes.
Oh. Would it surprise you to know that it's valued at over £40,000?
Well, it was a very good year, sir.
Yes, and a very good day for you too, Dobbs, when you flogged it.
Flogged it?
Flogged it. Now, come on, Dobbs. I can call in experts who'll prove that that wine down there is nothing but Van Ordinaire, and very ordinaire at that.
Yeah.
What do you mean, yeah?
I mean... You're right, sir. We disposed of it.
Who's we?
The General and I, sir.
Disposed of it?
Yes, sir.
You mean you flogged it?
No, sir.
Well, what did you do with it, then?
We drank it.
10,000 bottles? It's impossible.
Well, work it out for yourself. Bottle each night, General and his quartermaster, reliving past battles. I'll have to borrow from the bank. That's 14 bottles a week, 52 weeks a year. That's 14 That's about...
13.7 years.
Exactly. Ah-ha-ha.
Well, now, why did they replace it with that revolting red biddy?
Well, the wine was an investment. That's why. It's what is known in financial circles as a run on the liquid assets. Ha-ha-ha. Now, I'm sorry, Esther. I'm sorry. This time... There's no real reason to reopen the case.
Oh, go to jail. Move directly to jail. Do not pass go and do not collect £200.
I'm bored with this.
Esther, you've got to do something to get me out of here. I'm suffering. I've come out in a nervous rash, not to mention prison pallor.
Tony, you can't get prison pallor in 2 days.
I can.
Look, we've got to be constructive. The entries in those books show that you were embezzling £200,000. But you didn't, did you?
Esther, now you're losing faith in me.
Well, I'm trying very hard not to.
It's this place. Him. The whole scene. I'm labelled an enemy of society.
Let's assume somebody's trying to cook the books. Who do you think it could have been?
Only one of the three directors.
Yes, I've done their charts. Now, there's Rodney Tice. He's Capricorn. He's a rather cold, calculating sort of person. He's ambitious, very ambitious, and good at keeping his ideas and thoughts to himself. Accurate?
Spot on.
And there's Ian Renshaw, Pisces.
Suits him. Bit of a dreamy Daniels.
He gets carried away by his emotions. Likes to swim with the tide both ways at once. And there's Agnes Courtney.
Old Virgo.
Yes. She's a critical, analytical sort of personality. Was she ever in love with the General?
Yes. Office joke, had this secret passion for years. Used to get very upset about Julie Prentice.
Jealousy. It's possible, but I don't know. I just get the feeling that they were afraid.
Of what?
I don't know. I thought perhaps you could tell me. Something common to all three of them?
It's unlikely. They never agreed on anything except...
Except what?
Well, the merger. They were all united in opposing that.
What merger?
Well, the General was going to merge with another group. It really meant selling the bank. They were all against it. I think I was, too. But he steamrolled us. He always did.
If I may express, for the minutes, our deep regrets at the tragic events of the past few days. At the sad loss of our beloved chairman.
Hear, hear.
I think there is only one item we need to discuss as a matter of urgency, the proposed merger with Travers and Cronin. I will ask the board to reconsider the matter in the light of recent events. Mr. Rentoul, are you for or against the merger?
Against.
Miss Courtney?
Against.
The acting chairman votes against. Unanimous.
Hello. Sorry to trouble you.
What do you want?
Well, not me, Inspector Gradley. He wants you to have all the accounts and ledgers available for tomorrow morning.
All the... Why?
Well, I gather some men from the fraud squad are coming to examine them.
Fraud squad?
Oh, don't worry, it's just a routine audit. But he did ask me to ask you to keep it strictly confidential.
Tice. Yes? 7 points since the market opened. Sell our entire holdings. And buy Purse's Inc. at $84. And call me back.
Good night, Dobbs.
Good night, madam.
It's an amp!
Do you ever get this ringing in your ears? Esther, the telephone, it's ringing.
Oh, it's Agnes Courtney. I don't really want to speak to her right now.
Why would she call you?
Oh, the pressure's probably got too much for her and she wants to confess.
Where are you going?
Out.
Esther, come on. You're going to the bank, aren't you?
How do you know?
Because these are Tony Weston's keys.
Then I can't be done for breaking and entering,
oh,
can
yes,
I?
You can. It's still larceny, unlawful possession of a key. As a police officer, I can't allow this. Now, come on, hand them over.
Grad, I'm going to the bank. Agnes Courtney's there and she's expecting me.
All right, I'm coming with you.
Oh, no, you're not.
I consider it my duty.
Well, then reconsider it, because if you come, you'll just ruin everything. And besides, why waste your time? You've already arrested the guilty man.
Come on.
What are you doing here?
I realized you'd guessed when Miss Jones gave me that message about the fraud squad.
So it was you?
It was all three of us. Oh, I'm as guilty as the others, but... all those years, Horace led me to believe that... And then there was that Prentice girl.
So when Tyson Rentoul suggested the embezzlement, you went along with it?
were small amounts at first, and then more and more. But I swear I didn't know they were going to blame it on Tony. Oh, I realize he killed his father, and you must have other evidence, but... he did kill his father, didn't he?
All right, Esther, you can come home now. The money's in the tax-free Cayman Islands. Miss Courtney is sitting here in your favourite armchair. I've got the whole thing wrapped up. Esther? Esther?
Well, if she's there, who's here?
Esther! Esther!
You?
Yes. Don't move.
Who's moving? I must be losing my touch. It couldn't have been you.
Look, don't talk. Just pick up the phone.
How? You've cut the wires.
Not me.
Not you?
No, I was upstairs. I heard someone moving about.
Mr. Tice.
Miss Jones.
You have only a few moments left for conversation, Miss Jones.
I suggest that you drop your gun, Mr. Tice, or you'll find you've committed harikari.
Touche.
There.
Gosh, what a psychologist. You certainly fooled me. I thought you were an idiot. And all the time it was a bluff. Great work, Inspector. Beautiful, wasn't it, Esther? Arrest me, make the others relax, and then find out which is the real killer.
Congratulations, Grant.
While you're around, we citizens are in good hands.
Good of you to say so.
And I want to express my gratitude in positive terms. Huh? I didn't come empty-handed.
No, we're not allowed.
No, I insist. A dozen bottles of the old man's Chateau Lafitte. They don't make wine like this anymore.